Hello guys, welcome to complete Kotlin tutorial series for absolutely beginners. And in this video we're gonna learn about ArrayList, how the ArrayList are executed in our program. We're gonna see detailedly from scratch. So ArrayList also very important those who wanted to code better. Let's get started. Open our IntelliJ IDE tool and we are going to master about ArrayList in this video. So we are going to take a real world example for that. So val party list and we are going to create ArrayList angle brackets. We need to specify the specific data type to this particular variable. Assigning operator, we have to create an object for that ArrayList. So what is this object? So later in this code we will see what is this object. Now itself, assume that whenever you are going to create an ArrayList, you need to also create an object. So we have to specify the data type to this object, so string. Now we are going to add a persons to this party list.addJohn. So John is the first person is added, right? So let us copy this piece of code and add two more times, because we are invited the party only three numbers. Okay, now Lisa is also added to the party, invited to the party, and the Mark is also invited to the party. Now println statement, and we will say the first person is invited, and we will use concatenate operator, and then we will use party list. So let us run this application, and in the console you may see something like John, Lisa, Mark. So John, Lisa, Mark. Now if you wanted to get this value, that is the specific value, we can also get that, right? So party list dot get index. So you know that the John is at the index 0, Lisa is at the index 1, Mark is at the index 2. Now if you wanted to get the John, you need to keep here 0. Let us copy this piece of code and we will paste two more times, twice, and we will say party list dot get 1, party list dot get 2, and we need to also say here the first second person is invited to the party, that is Lisa, and the third person is also invited to the party, that is Mark. Let us run this application, and in the console you may see something like the first person is invited to the party, right? So who is that? That is John, right? Second person is invited to the party, that is Lisa. Third person is invited to the party, that is Mark. Now actually if you wanted to take all values which is stored in this party list array list, you can also do that. So let me actually create a new line in the console, and we will say println, and we will say all party numbers, and then we will use for loop to get the all the details of this array list. So for we create a variable to this for loop, my party numbers in range party list. We take this variable. Now let us print this. So println, whatever value stored in the party list array list is actually now in the variable my party number. So that's why I am referring my party number. Now you can see in the console we have printed all party numbers, that is John, Lisa, Mark. Now if you the Mark is not wanted to attend the party because he has some work, right? And we wanted to update the Mark. We are going to invite the Mark brothers Max. How can we do that? So we can easily do that by using this set method. So we will use party list dot set, and we need to actually first of all give the index of the set method index. So the index, we know that the index is 2, right? So 2 and comma, and I wanted to invite Max, either Mark, okay? And then we will use a println statement, println, and then we will say the party list dot get to get the index of this variable, right? So let me actually create a new line in the console. Now let us run this application. So now itself we have updated the mark as max, okay? So max is now invited to the party. So let me actually create a for loop to actually how many numbers are invited to the party. So print line, we will say print line again, and we will say all members, all party members. So party numbers, and we will take for loop over here. So for loop, we are going to create a variable to this for loop, my party numbers, and then in we will take, so you know that the range is actually 0, 1, 2, so it is means this is three values, right? So 0 to 2, 0 to 2, right? So 0, 1, 2, 3 values. So curly braces, we are going to println, use this value println, and we are going to set the party list index my party numbers. Now let us run this application. At this moment you're gonna see in this in your console we have max, not mark. So mark is now updated as max, right? So all party members John, Lisa, Max. Now if you wanted to use the if condition in your loop, I mean in your array list, sorry, this is not loop, right? So we will create a new line and we will say if, and we will say in the party list, party list dot contains. If you are going to use if condition in this array list, you have to use the contains method, okay? So party list dot contains max. If the max is contains, we need to print a value that is wow, max is invited to party, right? So max, wow, max is invited to the party, else invited, else we will say sorry, max is not invited. So println sorry, max is not invited. Not invited. Now let us run this application. So now itself it says wow, max is invited, because max is invited to this party, right? So this is how we use if condition in the array list, right? Now if you are going to use the for loop in the index, you can also do that. So let me actually create a new line, and we will say print line again one time, and at this time we will say party my all party. So let me type here all party members by index, by index, and then we are going to create a for loop, and we are going to specify the variable to this particular for loop, my party numbers, and this is very important over here. So by index, we will say by index, and this is very important in 0 to, so we have 0, right? And we can also use this value variable that is party list, right? If you are going to use this variable, you need to actually, this is not variable, right? Array list, sorry. So array list, if you are going to use this array list, you need to give here size, okay? So party list dot size, and so we have a problem over here. So party list is actually over here, we have three values, that is 1, John, Lisa, Mark, right? So John, Lisa, Mark. John is the index 0, Lisa is the index 1, Mark is the index 2. Now over here it says 0, right? So 0 to nothing but 0 to 1, 2, 3. So the values which has been evaluated over here, so it has 1, 2, 3. But we want 0, 1, 2, right? We want like that. So it means we need to subtract, we need to actually minus one thing from this method, from this value, right? So that's why we are going to use here minus one in our code. over after completing party list dot size. So minus 1. I think you have understood why we are going to use here minus 1, because we wanted to minus 1 value from this variable, because we have 0, right? So 0, 1, 2, that's all. Println, and then we are going to take the party list index my party numbers and then run this application. And now itself, it's gonna say John, Lisa, Mark, right? And if you wanted to actually remove one value from this array list, you can also do that. Play party list dot remove. So firstly we see remove, and then we will go for the remove it. So what is remove? If you are going to view here, remove is a element is nothing but a string value. So remove, if you are going to remove the max, you never see max in the console. And if you are going to use here remove it, so what happen if I use remove it? So remove it, let me cut out this code and we use remove it. And if you are going to use remove it, we need to actually specify the index value. So 2 is the index value, so we have removed max, right? And if you are going to use remove all, you will remove all values stored in the array list. So thank you for watching. See you tomorrow.